you like fruits and vegetables, then you care about pollinators. Over 80% of flowering plants worldwide rely on pollinators, primarily insects, to reproduce. In exchange for this service, pollinators get to eat nectar and pollen. That's their main food source. So how do plants attract pollinators, and how do pollinators find their flowers? Well, plants make signals for pollinators to find, like brightly colored flowers or floral scents. What is a floral scent? Imagine you're walking down a lane, it's summertime, you go by a lavender bush, and you get a lovely waft of that smell. That smell is just a chemical or group of chemicals hitting your nose. Your brain processes that and says, aha, lavender. Pollinators can do the same thing. They can recognize flowers by their scents and then follow those scents over long distances to their preferred flowers. However, atmospheric pollution could jeopardize plant-pollinator communication. Since the Industrial Revolution, there's been a dramatic increase in air pollutants, including the really reactive pollutant ozone. My research investigates how ozone could interfere with pollination at three critical stages. Firstly, ozone can damage flowers. My research shows that ozone makes some flowers smaller, meaning they're making less of a visual cue, and it can make flowers produce less nutritious pollen and nectar, diminishing the overall food supply available for hungry pollinators. Secondly, ozone may damage insect antennae. Antennae are how insects smell the world around them, so any damage to the antenna could make it harder for those insects to detect and follow those floral scents we were talking about. So that's a problem, but that is currently ongoing research. Thirdly, ozone could interfere with pollination by breaking apart chemicals that make up floral scents. My research shows that a common breakdown product for ozone and floral scents is formaldehyde. So going back to our lavender bush, imagine now that instead of smelling lovely, smells like formaldehyde. That's pretty gross. That's unattractive to us, and my research shows that ozone-degraded smells are also less attractive to pollinators. And that is a huge problem, because if pollinators can't find their flowers, they can't pollinate them, which would be devastating for agriculture. But there is a Hail Mary here, which is that some insects are really good learners. My research shows that a moth pollinator is able to learn ozone-damaged smells that it initially didn't like, if that smell is paired with a tasty nectar reward, just like Pavlov's dog. So in summary, ozone has the potential to really negatively impact pollination, which would have devastating effects on agriculture. But my future research will focus on understanding which pollinators will be able to learn ozone damage cues, catch that Hail Mary pass, and continue to pollinate even in polluted atmospheres. Thank you.